Hi friends, it's Sonia here and welcome back to my channel. I am so excited to share this new video tutorial on decoupage wall clock. So this was one of my very much pending list and I'm super happy that I could do it with beautiful and amazing decoupage papers from Nagashri Arts. This is the MDF base which I got and I am going to use this beautiful decoupage papers. I really loved this design and I thought of doing some fussy cutting work. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut along this postcard lines and I'm going to use that as my focal point on my clock. First I'm going to just measure and check if that perfectly fits on my clock, and yes it is. So now I'm going to cut along the borders of my postcard cause that is what I'm going to use on my clock. I think this looks good. Initially I thought of using all the postcards, the bigger ones which is attached to it, but later on I realized that I should cut one of the extra, the top layer or postcard piece, and I'm going to fussy cut that also. First I'm going to mark with my pencil the borders of my paper where I'm going to stick it, and remaining portion is going to be covered with my paint. So here I'm going to mark it with my pencil, and on the remaining portion I'm going to blend my chalk paints and give a nice background color to it. I'm going to cover all the borders, the remaining portions and all the edges with a nice this peach color chalk paint, and then I'm going to do some color blending with my faded lemon yellow color. Thank you. My first layer of chalk paint has already dried out and I've already started with my second color. So I'm just going to dab very small amount of yellow color on it, and I'm going to spread it just like the patches of work, because I want to have my peach color and this fade yellow color both as my background. To speed up the process, I'm going to use my heat gun here. I personally feel decoupage is really incomplete without stamping, because that is something which really highlights the papers, the beautiful designs of the paper. So here I'm going to use my customized stamp, and I'm going to use my Acaval permanent ink pad, and I'm going to stamp it on the background. Once I'm happy with my background, it's time to stick my decoupage paper, and I'm going to stick this with my Mod Podge. Apply a generous amount of Mod Podge and please make sure that you press your papers properly. Thank you. Initially, I thought I'll cut the extra papers, but this was really a pretty design and I did not want it to cut it. So I'm going to add my Mod Podge on the corners and I'm going to stick it on the side. Here I am going to dab my paper very generously with my sponge dauber and I am going to make sure that my paper has sticked very nicely. The corner of the paper was out and I really wanted to cut that, so here I'm going to use my craft knife and I'm going to trim off that portion. Now I'm going to make my hole in the paper, the decoupage paper, and with the help of scissors I'm just going to make it a little broader, and this is where we are going to fix our wall clock mechanism. To highlight my background paper and give it a little shabby chic look with a tinge of pink, here I am spraying a shimmer spray. You can use any of your colors you want. You can even use your acrylic colors or chalk paint colors, and even you can do the splashing work on it. It's time to highlight the borders and the edges, so I'm going to blend this brown color with my blending brush and I'm going to just do this on the edges to highlight my borders and give a little more rustic look to my papers. As it's a wall clock, I need to add the timings. So instead of sticking anything else, I thought why not to have my own texture paste and add a nice colorful texture paste instead of Instead of sticking any numbers or ready-made stamping, I just thought why not to use my stencil and my own texture paste. So here I'm going to use my white texture paste, add some colors to it unless I'm happy with it, and then I'm going to use my stencil and mark my block dates on it. Instead of having any ready-made numbers to it, I thought why not to have give a little texture to it. So here I'm using my texture paste. I'll add some colors to it till I'm happy with the color, and I'm going to use my stencil and I'm going to mark my timings with that. Here I'm going to use my Tim Holtz stencil and I'm going to mark the timings on the clock. I will be just mentioning the 12, 3, 6 and 9 with my texture paste. Now it's time to highlight the borders, and here I'm going to use my dauber and I'm going to highlight all my numbers, the borders of my clock. Both the finger daubers and the brush dauber has a completely different effect. This you can analyze only while working with this. So please do try these two different kind of blenders. They are available with Nagashi Arts and are really handy to use. Once I'm happy with my distressing and giving a nice effect to my borders, it's time to give a layer of Mod Podge to it. This is going to be the first layer of sealer to my wall clock. So this is how finally my wall clocks looks, and I'm super happy with this. I really hope you enjoyed this tutorial. I will be listing all the materials used in this video in the description box below. Please do check that, and if you have any queries, please do comment below. And if you want me to do some more videos like this, please do mention that which artwork you would like to see, and I will be very happy to do tutorials on that. Thank you so much for watching. Here I'm going to use this border stamp and I'm going to highlight my timing numbers with this. So I'm just going to do a fitted effect stamping on the sides of my number. Once I'm done with my stamping and all the technique, it's time to give the final coat of sealer to it. So here I'm using my water-based wood varnish. It's from Asian Paints and I'm going to give a nice two coats of my varnish to this. At the back, I'm just going to give one layer of my varnish because that part is not really visible and it will be not very exposed to the open areas or the sunlight. So I'm going to just add one layer of my varnish on the back side. To speed up the process, here I am using my heat gun, and then again I am going to let it dry for 24 hours completely. Now my base has dried out completely and it's time to fix up the mechanism. So I got this mechanism from Zero Arts only. They have everything you need for this clock making. Now you just need to open up the nuts and the screws and fix up the mechanism like I am showing in this video, and it's done. So I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. This was super easy and really exciting for me. I am attaching few more pictures of this wall clock and it looks really fab. Hope you will be doing one for your room soon. And for any queries, please do comment below. I will try to solve as much as I can and I will be more than happy to help you guys. Thank you so much for watching.